Hey friends, Ash here with GentsScents. Hope you're doing really well. Today we're going to be talking about 10 of the best blue fragrances for pretty much any occasion. In case for some reason you don't know what a blue fragrance is, they're fragrances that are super versatile, people-pleasing, compliment-pulling, attention-grabbing, stuff like that. They're very versatile, and a lot of times they also come in a blue bottle. So, yeah, not all blue fragrances come in blue bottles though, just most of them. These are the type of fragrances that you can put on a table next to your door, and when you're leaving, whether it's in the morning or in the evening, whether you're going on a date, whether you're going to the office or just going to the grocery store, they're gonna work. They are fragrances you don't have to think about at all. That's why sometimes they're called dumb reach fragrances. So I've got 10 of the best ones right here. Let's go ahead and jump into it. Let's go over them. Let's start off with the heavy hitters. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these out of the way. These are the fragrances that probably are gonna come to most people's minds first. They are hugely popular. So these fragrances, these first ones especially, are not gonna be the type of scent that makes you smell unique. They are gonna make you smell really, really pleasing, and they are gonna potentially pull you lots of compliments. It's just there are going to be other people wearing these fragrances wherever you live, because they're enormously popular. Let's start it off with the granddaddy of the blue fragrances, Bleu de Chanel, of course, from Chanel. This has grapefruit, incense, ginger, and vetiver as some of the notes in the fragrance, and this is the Eau de Toilette. There's also an Eau de Parfum version, and there's also a Parfum version. I personally like the Eau de Toilette the most for myself, but the Eau de Parfum is also really popular. The Parfum version is a little bit more expensive, and I feel like not quite as versatile as the Eau de Toilette and the Eau de Parfum version. I'm not saying that it's bad though, it just takes the Bleu de Chanel DNA and basically does what you would think. It makes it a little bit deeper, richer, better suited for cool weather, some might say. So this one has a fantastic opening, the grapefruit and the ginger. It really sparkles, it grabs people's attention. It's very bright, it's uplifting, but at the same time, you get this nice incense note that lends a little bit of smokiness to it, gives it a little depth. Bleu de Chanel is the fragrance of choice for Thanos because it is perfectly balanced. You have fragrance notes in here that are better for warm weather, some that are better for cool weather. All works together perfectly to make an enormously versatile scent. So Bleu de Chanel, definitely one that you should have in your arsenal if you're just looking for maximum wearability, versatility, and likability. Let's go from there to Dior's take on a blue fragrance, Sauvage. Once again, this is the Eau de Toilette, and just like Bleu de Chanel, there's an Eau de Parfum version, and also a Parfum version. Dior basically looks at what Chanel is doing and they're like, hey, is that selling well? And then Chanel goes, yeah, it's doing okay. Why? And Dior is like, no reason. I'm not going to copy it or anything. I won't copy your own work. Can we do that? We can do that, right? Come up with our own. Now, Dior Sauvage doesn't smell like Bleu de Chanel. It just accomplishes the same things. It's made for the same purposes. This one has bergamot, pepper, lavender, and ambroxan. Sauvage is louder than Bleu de Chanel. It's more in your face. Some people would say more abrasive, but it is actually more attention grabbing overall because it is so much more in your face. This one is really well known for having a peppery metallic opening. Again, there's a bit of citrus in there as well. Lavender as it dries down. Ambroxan is really what Dior Sauvage is all about, and took that note and just catapulted it to where you see it everywhere now. So Dior Sauvage, gotta know about that one. Massive compliment puller. Now let's say you want a fragrance that is not as expensive as those two, and you kind of want to split the difference between them. Versace Dylan Blue. Bergamot, incense, grapefruit, and ambroxan. So you're getting some of that incense-y feel like you get from Bleu de Chanel, but you're getting the ambroxan like you might get from Sauvage. So you're getting little bits and pieces from both of those fragrances, though Dylan Blue does smell like its own thing. This one is enormously popular because, like I mentioned, it is more affordable than Sauvage, more affordable than Bleu de Chanel. You can find this easily at discounters, whereas the other two, you're not gonna save very much if you do find them at a discounter. It has just as much wearability as the last two fragrances, just as much of a compliment factor, and it is just as easily a year-round fragrance as the last two. Now the last really big heavy hitter before we get into some more random ones, Yves Saint Laurent Y Eau de Parfum. This has apple, ginger, amberwood, and sage. This one, you're gonna be getting that green apple off the top instead of bergamot or grapefruit. It's a little bit different than there. And this one utilizes amberwood instead of ambroxan. Now, amberwood and ambroxan are in the same group of aroma chemicals, the same style of aroma chemical, but we're not gonna get into that here. Y Eau de Parfum really took the Y line and just catapulted it right to the top of lots of people's favorite fragrance lines lists. It is a huge, huge attention-grabbing fragrance, massively versatile. The new Y Le Parfum, I actually prefer myself. That came out this year, but my wife thinks that Y Eau de Parfum is better, and it's not close to her. This is actually one of her favorite fragrances as far as the smell goes. Just amazing as far as pulling positive attention. So if that's what you're after, get that one. Up next, we have L'Homme from Rojas. And this one is a little bit more of a daytime fragrance, maybe a little more of a spring, summertime fragrance. But like pretty much all blue fragrances, realistically, you can wear it whenever you want. People sometimes get scared of wearing a spring or summertime fragrance in winter because they think, oh, it's not gonna project enough, it's not gonna last long enough. But if you're spending most of your time indoors and it's air conditioned, then you don't really need to worry. If where you're at is gonna be 70 degrees all day and the only time you're out in the cold is if you're walking to your car, you can wear whatever you want. This one has blood orange, juniper, tonka, and cardamom. So when you see some of those notes like tonka and cardamom, you may think that it's gonna have more of this warmth to it, this sweetness, this heaviness, but it really doesn't. It also has pineapple in the top, but you don't get a whole bunch of that. It's actually more of a fresh, spicy fragrance with bits of citrus intermingled throughout. Really nice, really appealing, and that one grew on me a bunch. First time I smelled it, I thought it was okay, didn't really love it, but then as I wore it more, especially through the warmer months, I grew to appreciate it a lot. And thankfully, it's popped up at discounters, so now you can get it in like $35 range, and that is a really good price for that one. At retail price, it's okay. At 35 bucks, 40 bucks, it's awesome. Next up, we gotta go with this one, Aqua di Gio Profondo. Good old Aqua di Gio. People have been wearing fragrances from this line all year round, day or night, any situation, since the first one came out. So of course, one of the Aqua di Gios has to make this list. This one has rosemary, cypress, sea notes, of course, bergamot, and mineral notes as some of the notes in the fragrance. And it takes that Aqua di Gio DNA and modernizes it. Really though, that's what a lot of flankers do, isn't it? They just take an existing DNA and they're like, what's popular right now? Put that in there. The cypress and the rosemary give it a nice green touch, a little hint of green in there. Smells fantastic, like you would expect from an Aqua di Gio fragrance. Everyone is gonna love it. Of course, with it being an Aqua di Gio and the Aqua di Gio DNA is very apparent in here, it's not gonna be the most unique thing on earth. Because Aqua di Gio is the best-selling fragrance of all time. So if somebody is going to recognize a fragrance, it's gonna be Aqua di Gio. So keep that in mind. If you want something that's gonna set you apart from everybody, like a special unicorn and everyone's gonna go, wow, what are you wearing? I've never smelled that before. That's not this. But if you want nearly everyone to universally like what you smell like. Next up, Lunarosa Carbon from Prada. This is quite similar to this, Dior Sauvage, which we talked about earlier. Bergamot, lavender, metallic notes, and ambroxan are some of the notes in this fragrance, and it is, for all intents and purposes, Prada's take on Dior Sauvage. So basically, they took Dior Sauvage, that DNA, that style, and they Prada-tized it, if that's a thing, Prada-tizing. They made it a little smoother, not as aggressive, not as metallic, not as sharp. The same feeling is there, though, the same idea is there in Lunarosa Carbon as Dior Sauvage Eau de Toilette. Just like Dior Sauvage, big compliment puller, massive, massive versatility, and one benefit of Lunarosa Carbon is that you can usually find this for less than Dior Sauvage. So if you're wily and you shop at discounters, you can pick this up for less than Sauvage, get something really similar from a still premium brand. Up next, Montblanc Legend, which is basically Montblanc's take on Fierce from Abercrombie & Fitch. Montblanc has actually done things like this before, numerous times, where they look at a popular fragrance and they say, hey, I'll take that. So Abercrombie & Fitch, they made Fierce, and they said, wow, it's selling so well, this is great. We've got all this money from Fierce, we've got Fierce money just raining down. And Abercrombie was like, ah, oh, I love it. Let's spray so much Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce in these stores that when people walk in, they are breathing Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce. It is infusing with their lungs, and there are nanobots inside the Fierce that make them buy the Fierce for their entire lives. I don't think that's actually how that happened. Well, the nanobot part didn't happen. The other part did, though. And then Mont Blanc, they looked at that and they said, I want that. Lavender, apple, tonka, and pineapple, some of the notes in the fragrance. As soon as you smell it, yeah, Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce. You can tell that that's what inspired this one. That being said, though, it's a really good fragrance on its own. This is a huge compliment puller, massively versatile, not very expensive from discounters. There's a lot to like about this. It spawned some flankers. Probably the most well-known one is Legend Spirit, which smells like Invictus Aqua. So they did it again. But people love the Legend fragrances. They don't cost that much, they perform pretty well, and they smell great. Next up, we got one for the young guys, Invictus Legend from Paco Rabanne. The Invictus line of fragrances from Paco Rabanne, I don't really like a whole lot. But there's no denying how popular they are and how influential Paco Rabanne Invictus is. All you have to do is look at, I don't know, literally every single fragrance manufacturer on earth, and they all have an Invictus fragrance, an Invictus inspired by fragrance in their lineup. Sea notes, bay leaf, amber, grapefruit, some of the notes in this fragrance. I would pick this one over the original Invictus all day, every day. I would take this over Invictus Intense at this point as well. Maybe you could say Invictus Aqua in this lineup instead of Invictus Legend. But I think if we're talking just year round, Invictus Legend, probably a little more versatile than Aqua. So yeah, Invictus. If you want compliments, you're a younger guy, something to wear to the club, something to wear to a bar, potentially on a date, just don't go too heavy, don't choke your date out. Invictus Legend. And last up, let's go with one that maybe guys that are a little bit more mature would like. Century Blue from Dunhill. This one has mandarin orange, iris, ambroxan, and sea salt as some of the notes in the fragrance. The bottle's pretty interesting. Some people are gonna like that bottle, other people are not. It does have a magnetic cap, so that's a nice touch. And it is pretty large. It's a random size, actually. 4.5 ounces, 135 milliliters. Now, I'm not arguing, it's 35 milliliters extra over the usual 100 if you buy a full-size bottle, but just kind of weird. One good thing, though, even though it has this really unique design of the bottle and the size is quite large, the fragrance itself really is not expensive. I think it's about 35 bucks online. Might even be a little bit less than that, actually. Again, from discounters. So this one's gonna give you that ambroxan like many blue fragrances do, though it's not quite as heavy-handed in here as some of the other fragrances in this list. You get iris as well, which a lot of times smells powdery or makeup-y. Here it's more a light, fresh iris pop. And it also has that mandarin orange, so you get a bit of citrus in the opening, though it's not really a citric fragrance. That one is more of a mellow blue fragrance. It's not quite as aggressive. It's not maybe as arrestingly attention-grabbing as some of the other fragrances here, but it is a great dumb reach, easy fragrance to pull off. And even though I said mature guys would probably like this one, younger guys can pull this off as well. It's just super versatile, which is what this list is about. So there we go, guys. 10 different blue fragrances for any occasion. These ones you can pull off anywhere, anytime, and people are going to like them. There is not a fragrance in here that has anything off-putting. All right, guys, thanks for hanging out with me today. Thanks for your support. Stay safe out there. I'll see you tomorrow with another fragrance video. Adios.